Hi, let's talk about the erectile tissues. Erectile tissues include derivatives of the corpus spongiosum and derivatives of the corpus cavernosum. Let's first look at the corpus spongiosum derivatives. In terms of the spongiosum derivatives that are part of the clitoris, flanking the vestibule of the vagina, we have two vestibular bulbs. We can see one there, and the other would be there. Those vestibular bulbs are of the spongiosum, and they come together along the midline to also participate as a midline structure, the glans clitoris or glans of the clitoris. Within the penis, the corpus spongiosum derivatives include the bulb of the penis, and the spongiosum continues along the ventral portion of the penis, and then towards the distal penis, it expands as the glans penis. So looking here in a cross section or transverse section of the penis, we can see the corpus spongiosum there, and within it we can see the spongy or penile part of the urethra, which is transmitted through the corpus spongiosum. Now covering the bulb of the penis, we have bulbospongiosus muscle, which we can see here. And over here, the bulbospongiosus muscle has been removed so that we can see the vestibular bulbs. But that muscle would lie just superficial to the vestibular bulbs. And that bulbospongiosus muscle helps to apply pressure to the vestibular bulbs and to the bulb of the penis. The corpus cavernosum derivatives include for the clitoris, the crura of the clitoris, which are going to be in association with the ischiopubic rami. And we can see there is the left crus and the right crus there. The crura are going to come together along the midline to participate as part of the shaft or body of the clitoris. On the penis, the crura are also in association with the ischiopubic rami, and then they're going to ascend the shaft of the penis laterally. You can see them right there. In the transverse section, we can see the corpora cavernosa along the dorsal aspect of the penis. And we can see the deep arteries of the penis within the corpus cavernosa. Now the ischiocavernosus muscle is going to cover over the crura. We can see it very well here at the root of the penis. You can see those muscles right there. And they have been removed here from the crura of the clitoris so that we may see them, but they would lie superficially like that. And much like the bulbospongiosus muscle, the ischiocavernosus muscles are going to apply pressure to the erectile tissue to help maintain tumescence and an erection and help slow the flow of blood from any of the veins that are draining these tissues to help maintain tumescence or an erection. So we've discussed the derivatives of the corpus spongiosum and corpus cavernosum. Thank you for your time.